Hello friends, in this video we are about to see on how to use Max ERP software for any basic businesses. So we'll just log into the software first, and so we'll start with the masters menu. So we'll just create a couple of masters first. Let's say we create customers and say we can have the complete address details of the customer here. We can even search the customer by their mobile number, or if you have any short code for the customer, you can even search by the short code, and you can save this. We'll create another customer saying novelty. So after the customers, we can create vendors. Vendors are our suppliers. So any of your supplier name, we can just mention like after vendors, we will just create general ledgers. So all your office expenses, bank account, cash account, capital accounts can be created under general ledger. So let's say we create a couple of account heads here, let's say office expenses. So we'll just group them under expenses indirect. Same way we can create our bank account, saying let's say HDFC Bank, and define under bank accounts. We can have multiple bank accounts created here, let's say another bank account Kotak. So likewise, we can have all the other accounting heads here, capital accounts, partners, capital accounts, loan, advances, assets, liabilities, and we group them in the correct accounting group here. So after creation of the general ledgers, we'll directly jump to creation of products. So we'll just create a product name called drilling machine. It's a product name, Boss Drilling Machine. We even have an option of a regional name conversion here. So once we click this convert, we can have this converted into a Tamil language or Hindi language, whichever language we want. We can convert the name into that regional, specific regional language. We select Hindi here, this product will get converted into Hindi, Boss Drilling Machine. Same way we can even have Tamil language or any other regional language that is required. And we can use this for your printing purposes also. So we can just group them under drilling machines. We'll group under hardware and brand is Boss. We are selling in numbers, and we can have here the landing cost, let's say 1,000 rupees. Selling rate is 1,250, and we can quickly save this product. So likewise, we can create all the different products that are used in our businesses, and we even have an option to import all the customers, vendors and the product masters from Excel. So if you have all these masters defined in any Excel file, we can just import it quickly in one shot. After products, we'll directly go to purchases, and we have clear menus here, sales, purchase. The first half of the menu, so first half of the menu is all about transaction, second half is all about reporting. Same is the case with accounts and inventory. So if you have any other opening stock or opening balances, the opening stock has to be entered in the inventory opening stock. Even this can be imported from Excel. Same is the case with opening balances. So if you have all the opening balances in Excel format, we can even import those customer wise or account wise. So we'll quickly go to purchase and take a purchase transaction. That's a supplier bill number, the actual date, bill date, whether it's a cash purchase or a credit purchase. We're just mentioning the invoice amount at the beginning, and then we'll just select our vendor name, saying Surya Marketing. A performance graph of Surya Marketing comes at the bottom, and his mobile and email ID is missing, which is being alerted here. We'll just take the product, saying Boss Drilling Machine, and say we buy in 100 numbers. So supplier wise, product wise, previous supply rate history comes at the below. The last supply rate will get fetched automatically in the rate. So you can even verify on what rate you have purchased or how much quantity you have purchased at different prices in the history. So let's say we are buying this time at 950, and you have a couple of more products here. Let's say we have screws MS, 200 pieces at let's say 90 rupees, and we have cutting wheel, let's say another 50 pieces at say 10 rupees this time, and we can quickly save our purchase. So now it says there's a difference of 1 lakh. So our total we have mentioned here is 10,000, and the bill total as per the supplier bill is 1,13,500. So for now we can just save this as 1,03,500. Sorry, 1,13,500. So this way we will always have 100% accuracy while purchase entry. So even if you miss out on any single quantity or any other product, or if you have typed wrong rates, or you missed out on purchase expenses, we can even configure discounts in this if required. So in either case, this total and this total will match, and then only the transaction will get saved. So after purchase, we'll just go to inventory and see our stock summary report. So this gives us the complete detail. Under cutting wheels group, we have 50 pieces of this. Under drilling machine, we have 100 pieces of box, drilling machine and screws. After stock, we'll just go to the sales part of it. Sales, we can just select our customer name, let's say Novelty Traders. Five pieces. So customer wise, product wise, previous supply date history will be shown below. If we are selling this customer at 1300 this time, we can just change the rate here and we can save this. The software sends a WhatsApp message automatically once the bill is saved. So since the mobile number is not mentioned, WhatsApp is not being sent here. You can even have multiple print copies printed. After the print, we can have print formats like A4 quarter, A4 half, or A4 full size, however it's required. So right now it's kind of an estimate slip that we have generated here with the Boss drilling machine for Novelty Traders, and A4 quarter size printout has appeared here. You can send a WhatsApp of this print format from here also, as well as you can send an SMS with a PDF link, or you can directly email the print format. So in this demo, we have not enabled the GST module. If you have GST module enabled, the entire thing can be managed with complete GST returns. So we can manage complete end-to-end financial accounting and file our taxes using Max ERP. Now when we bill the Novelty Traders next time, his current outstanding is being shown here. There's a 12 month performance graph that comes at the bottom, and the next time when we bill the Boss drilling machine, it shows the rate as 1300. Our master pricing is 1250, which is being displayed here. We have 95 pieces of stock in hand, but since the product has been supplied to this customer at 1300 last time, the previous supply rate is being fetched by default. Let's say we are giving another 20 pieces of this, and the rate history shows on which date, again how many quantity we have given at this rate, as being shown here. You are even getting the regional name in the search, and this can even be used in the printout. And we can just quickly save this. So this time the print preview will even show us the old balance of the customer. So the account balance before this bill was 6,500, and this bill total is 27,650, and the net total is including both of this. So you can even print the old balance for the customers along, and you even have an option to configure discounts on the entire bill as well as individual product wise. So we'll just configure a basic discount option. You can have product wise discount percentage, or we can even have bill wise discount percentage as well as amount configured here. You just have to re-open the screen, and we are finding a discount column coming here, as well as discount percentage as well as amount coming here. We'll see an example of this too. Let's say we are billing to Shankar Traders and Boss drilling machine 10 pieces. The default selling rate of masters have come. Since we have not sold this product to Shankar Traders earlier, the master rates are applicable. Let's say we are selling this product at 1275 at a 2% or 5% discount. And then to round off the bill, we can even have a direct rounding, like 13 rupees discount here. 14,800 can be directly rounded, and you can save this bill. So likewise, we can generate the bill, and once coming back to the stock summary again, if we click show, now it shows the current stock status here. even an option of detail stock summary. So detail stock summary will show you the opening of the product. There was no opening stock entered, the total inward of the product, outward of the product, and the closing stock left. So when we see cutting wheel or the, let's say, the boss drilling machine, so opening was nil, inward was 100 pieces, outward 35, and closing stock left with us is 65. You can just press enter and see the details here. So this will tell us and show us the purchase detail, where inward has happened and when all outward has happened. And you can just press enter to on any of the transaction to see the detailed. And there are a lot of other reports, like in sales register itself you can even track profits. So you can just click show and it will show you the sales of the day, total cash sales and the credit sales. You can go to options and you can just click show profits. So this will generate bill wise profit reports for you, and you can just see the cost value and the profits made against each bill and the profit margin. You can even see product wise profit in the bill by using the key shift F12. So in the shift F12 key, it will show you the cost rate of the product, the cost value of the total product, and the selling rate and the profit made and the margin and on the bill. This can be done across multiple products also, where if you press shift F12 on the bill, it will show you the profits on individual product wise that is made on the bill. You can even see your sales summary group wise, like total product group summary, under which product group, how much quantity you have sold in that particular date range. So you can see the sales for a month or for a week, any date range that you want. You have multiple reporting options here which you can explore with the demo. So after the sales, we'll just move into the accounts part of it. In the accounts, we can just go to outstanding and we can see bills receivable. This will show us all the bills which are receivable. So normally traders, we have two bills which are still pending, we have not received the payment for this. And chunker traders, there's a credit bill for 14,800. Same way, we have an option of bills payable, which we're showing shows the vendor wise. So we have one purchase bill from Surya Marketing of 1,13,500, which is yet to be paid. You can even see the ledger parallelly. So let's say we just open the ledger for novelty traders, and this will show us a complete transaction with the product details. You can even take out the product details if you don't want. And once you come to this, it shows that we have two sales bill and total outstanding is 34,150. Now if we are receiving a payment from the novelty traders, we can just go to accounts, select receipts. And if we are receiving cash or through bank, whichever account where we are receiving, we can just select it. And let's say we just select the novelty traders. So it says 34,150 is the bill amount. And if you are receiving a partial payment, like let's say 20,000, so you can just select 20,000 here, and this will get adjusted against the respective bill. We even have an option of rounding of the discount. So let's say if we are rounding 150 rupees or providing 150 rupees in discount in this particular bill, we can even mention the discount option here, and we can mention any remarks and save this transaction. Now coming back to the ledger of novelty traders, now if we see, so it says that we have a receipt of 20,000 and 150 rupees discount we have given. The rounded closing balance for the novelty traders account is 14,000 rupees, which is yet to be received. You can even see the bill wise details here. Now earlier it was two bills, now it's only one bill which is pending, and out of 27,650 we have only 14,000 rupees balance left. You can open the plus sign and see the transaction detail on how the adjustments have happened. So it shows here that we had a receipt of 13,500 and a discount provided against this bill for 150 rupees. Same case is there for the vendors also. If you're making a payment to your vendors, you can go to accounts payment screen, and current cash balance in hand is 20,000 rupees. We can make the payment, which this cash balance we have just received from the novelty traders, so current cash balance is getting loaded here automatically. And we are making a payment to Surya Marketing, and we can just, the current outstanding shows as 1,13,500. So even if we are requesting a discount for the vendor while payment, we can even make a payment of, let's say, 13,900 here, and 500 we can provide discount against this bill after confirmation with the vendor if there's anything. And we can just type remarks and save it. So now if we see ledger of Surya Marketing, so it will show us that the purchase bill for 13,500, and then we have made a payment of 13,000 rupees, and we have claimed a discount from the vendor against this payment for 500. 1 lakh is the rounded balance left. You even see the same details in the bills receivable with the adjustment details here. So this adjustment details can even be like a purchase return adjusted against purchase, or payment made against the purchase. So all that adjustments can be seen right in the bill, in the report. Apart from this, we have a lot of MIS reports where you can see our top 10 customers, top 10 suppliers, or We have so many account wise, product wise report, or product wise, group wise report. So you can even see like account wise, product wise details report and with the profit details. So it will just show you which product has been sold to which customers, at what quantity, what rate, and what was the profit made. You can even see the detailed report here. Instead of summary, if you want the detailed bill wise, you can even see bill wise details. So Boss drilling machine has been provided to novelty traders 2 times with different quantities and different rates, and the profits are being shown here. You can just click print and either email, SMS or WhatsApp any report or any ledger statement to your customers, and even stock reports can be mailed to any of the contacts directly over WhatsApp. So even if you have a ledger statement here, you can just click print and you can click it or send it over a WhatsApp here by clicking this. So a PDF will get attached automatically, and if the mobile number is mentioned in the customer master, it will get loaded automatically, or else you can type your mobile number manually and send it across. So that's all with this demo, and hope you liked it. So stay tuned for next set of videos to come, and thanks a lot for watching this video.